After yet another title defense at UFC 320, Merab Dvalishvili has established himself as one of the best to ever do it in the bantamweight division. He broke the record for most takedowns in UFC history, having attempted 37 takedowns against Corey Sandhagen. But what is the underlying biology that enables him to perform at levels above the competition? Meet erythropoietin, commonly known as EPO, a glycoprotein hormone that stimulates red blood cell production in response to low oxygen levels. In short, more red blood cells lead to more oxygen to tissues, leading to more takedowns, and of course, the caucus special. Before diving further, it's important to understand the difference between two key terms, endogenous and exogenous. Endogenous means that something is produced within the body, think growth hormone or insulin. Exogenous would mean it originates from outside the body, think like normal PEDs. EPO is found endogenously in natural amounts and actually helps stimulate normal production of red blood cells. But here's where it gets interesting. When the body senses low oxygen, like during intense training or after 5 rounds of a UFC event, the kidneys will start releasing more EPO. This hormone then tells your bone marrow to produce more red blood cells. The result? More oxygen delivery, more endurance, and more minutes of Merab shooting takedowns and throwing knees to the thigh. Erythropoietin is mainly produced by special cells in your kidney, called peritubular interstitial cells. These cells act like oxygen sensors. Basically, when oxygen levels will drop in your blood, they'll activate a gene that's called HIF-1-alpha, short for hypoxia-inducible factor 1-alpha. This gene basically acts as a biological alarm bell.
Breathe air!
Once it's triggered, it signals the kidneys to release more EPO into the bloodstream. The EPO then travels through your blood to the bone marrow, where all your red blood cells are formed. There, it binds to specific EPO receptors on immature red blood cell precursors. These are called erythroid progenitor cells. When EPO binds, it flips a biochemical switch that tells cells not to undergo apoptosis, otherwise known as programmed cell death, and rather they're told to continue to divide and proliferate. The result is an increased hematocrit, which is otherwise known as like increases in blood cell count, but more specifically, you'll get more hemoglobin in the body, the protein that's responsible for transporting oxygen and allowing it for its delivery to tissues. The amount of EPO that we produce endogenously varies from person to person. Merab, for example, certainly has a higher amount of EPO than the average person because of the extensive training that he does. This is because of increases in the efficiency of EPO release. As you train, you expose your tissues to a hypoxic environment, that of low oxygen. This in turn leads to your body to release more EPO. The more you repeat the cycle, the easier your body will adapt to releasing the hormone. It's basically a hormonal muscle memory. On top of that, it's likely that Merab has the genetics to go alongside this training regimen, as some people will have variants of the EPOR gene, basically the gene that codes for the receptor of EPO. Some may get a receptor that activates with smaller amounts of EPO, leading to more efficient and sensitive responses. But that's probably not why you're here. You really want to know about exogenous EPO. Now that we understand how EPO works naturally, it becomes easier to understand why it can be so effective as doping agents for athletes. Exogenous EPO, or synthetic erythropoietin, is basically a lab-made version of the same hormone your kidneys produce. It was originally developed for patients with anemia, especially those with kidney disease, because it helps them make enough red blood cells to carry oxygen. The natural adaptation and boost in system efficiency that comes from years of training can be achieved at the low, low cost of 3 injections in the backside. Pair that with someone who trains constantly like Merab, you get a 100% efficient EPO goblin. There are risks associated with this kind of doping, the main being an increase in blood viscosity. Basically, the blood becomes thicker and it gets harder to pump, increasing the risk of clotting, heart strain, and strokes. So how does USADA and other anti-doping organizations even catch someone using EPO? You'd think it'd be easy. Just look for the hormone in their blood, right? Not quite. EPO testing is one of the most sophisticated forms of anti-doping detection in sports. The problem is that endogenous and exogenous EPO are almost identical. So comparing the molecules on a broader level can't really tell you the nature of where they come from. If you focus on specific aspects of the molecule, like its structure and its charge, you can start to tell one from the other. For example, the isoelectric focusing is one such test done by USADA that separates proteins within a molecule based on charge. If synthetic EPO has a slightly different charge from endogenous EPO due to structural differences on the sugar backbone, they can tell. SAR-PAGE is another test that separates EPO molecules based on size, allowing labs to compare them against known synthetic variants. They also monitor athletes through the athlete biological passport, which is essentially a comparison of athletes' biomarkers over time. In summary, what Merab did at UFC 320 was a combination of incredible skill and Caucasus Mountain genetics. There was absolutely nothing else in play, nothing else that influenced how he attempted 37 takedowns in 25 minutes. I don't know about you, but I'm putting the house on him for his next fight because of his incredible willpower and skill and absolutely nothing else. Those are the only two reasons. Thank you guys very much for watching. I'd love your feedback on this kind of video and ways in which I can improve it because it's the first time I'm doing this and I'm sort of figuring out the format of it. If you enjoyed it or learned anything at all, please don't forget to subscribe. It'll help out a ton. Thank you very much.